As a monk, the Venerable Losaka went on alms rounds every day. Whenever someone gave a spoonful of food to the Venerable Losaka, his bowl would appear full to everyone. This was due to his past karma. Everyone who saw him would then give their alms to other monks instead. The Venerable Losaka experienced immeasurable suffering throughout his life. This led him to dedicate himself to practicing the Buddha's teachings in order to free himself from future births. The Venerable Losaka contemplated on the inherent suffering of life. He saw that all things started and ended with suffering. Through his realization of the truth of life, he released all attachments. He attained full enlightenment as an arahant, never to be reborn again. Even as an arahant, the Venerable Losaka still had to pay for his past karma. He never received enough food for a full meal. However, he only suffered physical karma and did not suffer emotional karma. After many years, the Venerable Losaka was nearing the end of his life. The Venerable Sariputta reflected on his student and thought,
"My student will pass away today. I will see to it that he has enough to eat."
The Venerable Sariputta then invited the Venerable Losaka to join him for alms in Sawati. As popular and well-loved as the Venerable Sariputta was to the people of Sawati, when he was standing next to the Venerable Losaka, he was not able to collect even a bowlful from the lay people. The Venerable Sariputta then contemplated that the Venerable Losaka's karma must be very strong indeed. The Venerable Sariputta then asked the Venerable Losaka to return to the temple. After he left, the Venerable Sariputta received more than enough alms. He then asked some laymen to bring the food back, but they forgot and ate it all themselves. When the Venerable Sariputta returned to the temple, he went directly to the Venerable Losaka.
"Did you get the food I sent to you?"
"No, sir, I did not."
"Then please wait here."
The Venerable Sariputta went to see King Pasenadi of Kosala with his alms bowl. The king took his bowl and returned it with the four types of sweets that monks are allowed after noon. When he returned to the temple, the Venerable Sariputta called the Venerable Losaka to him. He said,
"Venerable Losaka, come, eat this food, but I must hold the bowl, otherwise the food will disappear."
"Sir, my preceptor, you've been beyond merciful to me. You've done so much for me already. I would not wish to burden you any further."
"Losaka, do not say that. Come, eat this food. I am happy to help one who has practiced as diligently and properly as you."
"Venerable sir, I will do as you wish."
With deep appreciation, the Venerable Losaka ate the food directly out of the Venerable Sariputta's bowl. For the first time in his life, the Venerable Losaka knew what it felt like for his stomach to be full. The Venerable Sariputta made sure that the Venerable Losaka ate as much as he wanted to. Later on, that very same day, the the Venerable Losaka passed away. The Lord Buddha himself oversaw the funeral. After the funeral, the arahant relics of the Venerable Losaka were collected out of the ashes and stored in a shrine.
What did you learn from this story? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads. And consider making a donation to support our Buddhist animation project.